the word resonator, if you hear this word, so what is resonance? So resonance means when the applied frequency and the natural frequency, when both matches, then the vibrations will be at maximum amplitude. So if the particle will vibrate with maximum amplitude and the amplitude will be maximum. So in this experiment, we are going to do the same thing. So we are in this, this is your resonating tube, okay? And here this is our beaker which is used to collect the water, okay? And we have, I will show you the tuning fork also after some time. So we will use this tuning resonating tube, and inside this we have filled with water. So what I will do, I will apply some frequency. So if that frequency is matching with the frequency of the tuning fork and matching with the frequency of an air column which is present inside this resonating tube, if both are matching, then you will have a resonance. And at that point, if you vibrate your the sound waves will vibrate with maximum amplitude, and we will hear a maximum sound, maximum loud sound. The amplitude of the sound will be maximum. So we'll start this experiment in that way. Okay, so here, if you see, here we are having, this is a setup. So in this we are having, this is a resonating tube. Here we are having a collecting beaker. This is my tuning fork. I will keep it here. Okay, and then we will do some calculation and we get the answers. So how to start with it? We have to first start with finding the volume of a neck, that is neck correction. Then for different frequencies. So I will take different frequencies, and then I will find the volume, resonating volume, air, volume of a resonating air with the help of this instrument. And I will repeat the same for same frequency thrice. Okay, so I will repeat it thrice, and then I will find the mean of it, and hence we can get the value of 1 upon n square. And after plotting the graph, we'll try to find the value of the k, which is the unknown frequency. So we will try to find the value of unknown frequency and the neck correction from the graph also. Okay, so that is our entire aim to what we will do in the experiment. So how to start with this? So if you see, this is my resonating tube, okay? And here we are having, here these are the tuning fork. So since we will be using only five readings, one is extra for unknown frequency. So in the set of reading, we will take one unknown frequency, okay? And that we will take it as last. So first we'll try to find the five different readings, okay? So you can take many also, more readings also, but for our experiment, we have to take only five readings. So how to start with it? To start with it, first I have filled the entire resonating volume, okay, till the top. Now you have to remove the volume of a neck. So that neck volume you have to remove. So I will open it very slowly. Okay, very slowly I have to open. So now some water is going down. Okay, I will stop here. Okay, so this is my neck correction, which is volume of a neck. So I will measure it. So if you measure it, it's around 5.6. So if you see here, it's around 5.6. So the volume of neck is around 5.6. Okay, so that you have to keep it in your mind. Now the volume of a neck is, I have got, that is 5.6 cc, centimeter cube or ml, both are same. So ml or centimeter cube, both the things are same. So neck volume of neck is around 5.6 cc. Now we'll start with the actual experiment. So I will keep my beaker down, okay, and I will start with the maximum frequency, because that maximum frequency will have the minimum volume, okay, so because the maximum frequency is maximum. So I will tap this on a rubber, then I will hear the sound. So if you try to hear the sound, we are not getting any sound here. So it's not audible only. Okay? So nothing is audible. So now what I will do, I will increase the volume of air. So to increase the volume of air, we have to remove the water from it. So to remove the water, I will open it. I will open this. Now the water has started going down. Okay? So till the water goes down, we have to check it. It's not audible. very slow sound is coming. Still we are having low sound. We have to tap it continuously, okay? No sound, very slow. Yeah, now if you hear it very, if you listen it, then we can hear the sound. That sound is coming. So if it is coming, I will stop here. So we have started getting the sound, louder noise. I will tap it. Then I will open it very, very slowly. Drop by drop. Okay. Yeah, you can hear the sound. So now if you hear it, the sound is maximum. Okay? Yeah. So now I have got the maximum sound. Now we will see the reading. So if you see the reading, it's around, if you look it carefully, it's around 66 ml. So my reading has come around 66 ml. Okay. Now we will try to verify whether that is the correct one or we have to do a little more. So I will open it very, very slowly. Yeah, it's moving drop by drop. Okay, after that 66 is going decreasing. Yeah, volume has decreased. Yeah, now it has decreased. Means that value which we have taken, that was 66. At 66 we have got the maximum reading. Okay, so to check it again, we will just fill it little more water here. And then we will again check it. More than 70, so we are getting less reading. I will take it around 64. Okay, fine. So at this value, if I tap it, yeah, you can see. Okay, so. So at again at 66 ml, so my frequency was 512 hertz and the volume which we have got is around 66 ml. Okay, so this is my one reading. Now what we have to do, we have to repeat this again. So we have to again fill the entire volume. We have to take the entire volume, fill it again inside this. Okay, don't have to take the neck correction again. And you have to take the again with the help of same frequency, you have to take again the same reading. So I will take one more reading. This is the one first reading. I have to take the second reading and you have to take the third reading for the same amplitude. Okay. So and after getting all the readings, you have to find the mean. So I will get the mean. So I will take three readings of the same with the help of same frequency. So for same frequency, I have taken three different readings, three different sets of readings. And then the mean, you will get the value of the air volume. Okay, so air volume at which the resonance is occurring, that we will try to find with the help of the first one. So with this we have completed the one set of reading. Then what I will do, I will change my frequency to 24. So now I will do it with 480 hertz. Okay, so you are allowed to take any of the tuning four. So I will take from the set of the tuning fours which are available, I will be taking 4 to 5. 5 tuning non-tuning four, and then take the reading, and one I will take it unknown one. So this is my unknown frequency, which we don't have the value. So this value we will try to find with the help of a graph. Okay. So I will take this and I will repeat the procedure again, and I will get the resonant condition. Okay. And after getting the resonant volume, the air volume, resonant air volume. So I will put that value in the graph, and after putting the value on the graph, you can calculate the value of the frequency. Okay, so that's the entire experiment, and in this experiment, if you want to find the frequency, any unknown frequency, so that unknown frequency can be calculated with the help of this experiment. So this is it. So in this we can do that, we can find the unknown frequency. Okay, so I hope you have understood it, and if you have any doubt, you can send me your doubts to in the chat box. Okay.